I don't want to make music in a city. I want to go somewhere inspiringly beautiful. Because the further away you get from civilization, the stronger the voice of what I think is good becomes. Magnificent year of my life. Day after day after day of things happening that I didn't expect. Every person in the band has become completely essential after this year of touring. And that's what I wanted. I wanted to form a band of brothers. The first band member I met was Arnie. He was just brilliant, eccentric, funny, open. Sam is just so laid back. You know, he's a really subtle player but can really rip it up if he needs to. Just as importantly, he's got great personality. I can't tell you the amount of compliments I get about Luke's playing. He really is an incredibly special drummer. Kenny has just got an absolute megawatt personality. Give him some drink and the guy is a train. It's the energy of the man is unbelievable.
Me and the guys are on the road, on our way to Skye. It's bumpy, but we've flown from Ireland to Glasgow. And driving from Glasgow Prestwick Airport over to Skye to find Steve Osborne, who's found the studio by the sea where we're going to record a little live album.
Hello!
Welcome home!
How are you? Hello!
Oh, this guy here, yeah.
How are you?
Hey guys.
You're alright?
Yeah.
Hello! Happy Christmas!
You too. How you doing?
Yeah, really good.
We all decided last night that instead of doing the album remake, we're going to do something a little bit more unorthodox, which is great. And we're going to do some B-sides and a couple of new songs. So we've got quite a crazy little set list that we didn't expect. I've noticed that if the guys let it get to them, they're a bit nervous. And I haven't been, but I know the stuff really well because I wrote it and they've only played it. You know, some of the tunes they've only played once and a couple of them they've not played at all. But it's good for us to do that. Definitely.
We arrived here last night very, very late. I'm very, very tired. And we're hoping, having now finished our breakfast, that we're going to go to the studio and everything will be set up and ready and it will be an absolute breeze.
Hey, Graham.
But none of us really know what the hell we're doing. We don't even know half the songs that we're doing. So it's going to be pretty damn interesting.
Howdy. How are you
get
doing?
In here now.
Because I'm playing a C without an E. It's quite nice being open like that.
Yeah. Even D.
Just without an E.
But no D.
When do you play a D and your C, but?
If you take it, if you're not playing an E though, you've got a D string, but you're not playing
yeah,
it.
Yeah, no, I'm just muting it.
Okay.
I think I'm playing.
Okay.
Yeah. So just try open C, G chord. Scottish. I'm playing shuffly, like. I have this incredibly bossy child in me that thinks she's right all the time. It's a very strange sensation when you're actually in the process of playing something and it's just so impulsive and you just know it's right and you know it's going to be better like this. Is definitely the guru of my present life. He's the Tom Waits to my Joni Mitchell. That's what I needed, was someone to bring this masculinity to the music. And I knew it was what I wanted, but I didn't know how to do it. And he just had this brilliant plan all worked out. You know, I met him and he had these big bags under his eyes and he was twitching and he was, you know, he was really jittery and I just thought, he's brilliant. He's absolutely perfect. I want a producer who looks like that because he's into the music. This is our studio. This is Chris's living room. Chris is the guy who organised the Isle of Skye festival that we did in the summer. And we've invaded his house. This is his living room. And this is where Sam is. Arnie is here with his cello and bass. I'm on the seat with the plush cushion. Donna's on the box in the corner. Kenny's in the corner and Luke's here.
We're still doing our wah-wahs and claps, aren't we?
Not the beginning.
I thought you guys were always singing om, because Kenny sings like that.
No, I can always hear you sing om.
From here on, let it be om.
Channels 6, 7 and 8, down at least a notch, maybe two. Can you give me some welly in the kick, please?
Some what?
A bit more volume in the kick, as loud as you're going to do it.
It was always the plan, to find a front room. I just can't believe this guy is cool with us coming to his house for the 3 days before New Year. I'm convinced that people do this all the time. People always record stuff in their living room. This is what I was doing for a long time before getting a record deal. And tons and tons of hundreds of thousands of bands record like this. But it's just that once you get a record deal, you don't need to. But I happen to really like it. I love it, and I don't want to stop doing it.
I think she's brilliant, I really do. I think she's the best I've worked with, without a doubt. She's great. She has a real natural feel and instinct for writing a song. And she's got a voice to back it up, and she plays guitar like a mean mother. So, yeah, she's ace, man.
Lifestyle-wise, I just want to keep it simple. And I don't want to get lost. And so doing a project like this really, really, really feeds that and really helps that. Helps me to know where I am. Put your hands on the wheel, let the golden age begin. With the window down, feel the moonlight on your skin. It could be a subconscious effort to remain grounded with all the madness of it. There's a